here we are given a less than cumulative frequency distribution showing the less than values along with their frequencies. But we need to find the median of this distribution. Let's read the data given here. There is no value less than 38. There are three values less than 40. There are five values less than 42. There are nine values less than 44. So this is how we read the data. There are 35 values less than 52. So this is what is given to us. So this is called a less than cumulative frequency distribution. And we need to find the median of this distribution. To find the median, we need to first prepare its corresponding frequency distribution showing the class intervals along with their respective frequencies. We'll see how to do that. The values which you see alongside the less than symbol, see here, less than 38, less than 40, these values which we see along the less than symbol represent the upper limits of the class intervals. You can just ignore the first one because the frequency is 0. So what are the other values you see here? 40, 42, 44, 46, 48, 50 and 52. So these values form the upper limits of the class intervals. Alright? Now using these you can fill the lower limits. So if the upper limit of the class interval here is 40, it will be the lower limit of the next class interval. The upper limit of this class interval is 42, that will be the lower limit of the next class interval. The upper limit here is 44, that will be the lower limit of the next class interval. So 46, 48 and 50 here. So going by this rhythm, it should be 38 here. 42, 40, it must be 38 here. So this is how we generate the class intervals using the less than values. So here we have the class intervals. Next is to find the values in the frequency column. Remember, these values are actually the cumulative frequencies and not the frequencies. So we need to generate the values in the frequency column. How do we do that? Write this first value 3 as it is. So 3 is the frequency of the first class interval. 3 is the frequency of the first class interval. Now find the difference between the two quantitative cumulative frequencies. 5 minus 3, 2. So 2 is the frequency of the next class interval. Next, 9 minus 5, 4 will be the frequency of the class interval 42 to 44. Next, 14 minus 9, 5 will be the frequency of this class interval. 28 minus 14, 14. 32 minus 28, 4. 35 minus 32, 3. So what did we do? We wrote the first, ignore this one. With the frequency 0 or the cumulative frequency 0. Ignore this one. Write the first frequency as it is. To generate the other frequencies, keep subtracting. Keep subtracting like this to find the other frequencies. Now, after getting the class intervals and the frequencies, we need to create or generate another column called the cumulative frequency column. How do we get these values? Write 3 as it is. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 plus 4, 9. 9 plus 5, 14. 14 plus 14, 28. 28 plus 14, 32. 32 plus 3, 35. And as always, see here, the last cumulative frequency should be equal to the total of the frequency column. 35. So now we have the table ready to find the median. So the table must have class intervals, frequencies and the cumulative frequencies. So we start with finding the value of n by 2. The value of n is 35. 35 by 2, 17.5. Now look at the cumulative frequency column. find that value in the cumulative frequency column which is just more than 17.5. And the value that is just more than 17.5 is 28. Correct? And the corresponding class interval is the median class. So clearly 46 to 48 is the median class interval. We know that this is the formula to find the value of the median. Median is equal to L plus N by 2 minus CF by F into H. What is L? L is the lower limit of the median class, 46. What's the value of N by 2? 17.5. Minus, what is CF? The cumulative frequency of the class preceding the median class. So this is the median class. This is the class interval preceding the median class interval. The corresponding cumulative frequency, 14. So 14 here. What is F? F is the frequency of the median class interval. So this is the median class interval. The frequency of the median class interval, 14. Into H. H is the width of the median class interval. The width of the median class interval, 48 minus 46, 2. So the class intervals are continuous. How do we find the width? Simply the difference between the upper limit and the lower limit. 48 minus 46, 2. So we filled all the values in the formula. Simplify, calculate this. So the median of this data is 46.5.